animal study. So that's what we need. You need a one time and cure. What you don't want is, you have one drug, and you live another 1 year, then you recur, and then you die, then another day you develop another drug, then another patient, then live for another year, then die again. What we need is something, just cure. We need a magic bullet, and it's coming. In addition to the one I just mentioned about combination therapy, there's another new type of therapy. And many people today, when I talk to the scientists here, that everybody's known this so-called new immunocheckpoint therapy. So we don't have to use a jargon of the scientific jargon, immunocheckpoint, that's not important. A simple term is, make yourself very healthy. Enhance your immune response. You wouldn't have no cancer. Because all the anti-cancer drugs we are using are useful. They are target cancer cell, but without that, you and I sit here and stand here because we have our immune system to fighting for us. I might have cancer cell hanging around right now, but there's no symptom because I have an immune response. Kill them. And this immunocheckpoint therapy developed, original concept developed by Jim Allison, who is currently working in MD Anderson with my colleague, that the concept is, how can you boost up your T cell activity, enhance your immune response, and then use your T cell to kill the cancer cell? Keep in mind, the earlier drug I mentioned is target therapy. It's develop a drug to kill cancer cell, but cancer cell is very smart, they develop resistant, right? But this is different. This one is you enhance your immune response. And when you enhance your immune response has memory. It's always there. So usually when you treat cancer, you have to eat a drug all the time. That's why they develop resistant, the cancer cell. But this, you treat it a couple of times, you finish. Because your memory. And so their therapeutic effect lasts for a long time. And this kind of drug now, the first drug FDA approved anti-CTLA-4 was developed by Jim Allison, and that was approved several years ago, treat with the melanoma. And then more recent development, this drug also been approved by FDA just last year in melanoma and lung cancer, and there will be more, multiple solid tumor. What I know now is there are at least several hundred clinical trials cover virtually all major cancer type from whatever cancer you want to mention. There are clinical trials using this one because to boost up your immune system. So the general concept is eat healthy, exercise, maintain good mood, smile all the time. I'm not kidding. If you're depressed, your immune response is going to go down. If you're in good mood, your immune response is going up, and that helps you defend yourself. I really mean it. How many people see those old couple love each other so much, husband and wife, when one person die, the other person die very quickly because they're depressed. Okay? So this is essentially tell us there's another type of therapy came out. I'm not saying this magic, this one is going to cure cancer, but this immunocheckpoint therapy at this moment in the cancer therapy is a revolution concept, and the clinical trial, it's working so well, but there are still room to be improved. And then I know the scientists in City University, some of you are also interested in that. We're working on that too. So this needs us to really work on it and to make it perfect. And we owe this very positive example. I'm try to convince you cancer is not that terrible. But cancer is still cancer. There are several types of cancer, brain tumor, pancreatic cancer, it is still very difficult to cure. My friend, very difficult to cure doesn't mean you cannot cure it. It's a matter of time. And I'm very confident on that. However, I still want to show the data. 5-year survival rate for pancreatic cancer is pretty bad, especially when the late stage, stage 3 is only a couple percent 5-year survival rate. Pretty much say pancreatic cancer is just bad, okay? And then, very interesting, 1998, there's a drug. And that time, I was doing the cancer therapy research. When I saw this curve, I was very not impressed. I was mixed feeling. In 1998, there's a drug called gemcitabine. Before this one, the only drug treated with the pancreatic cancer is 5-FU. Okay, and in 5-FU, the 5-year survival rate is 2%. But 1998, gemcitabine is a very famous drug now developed by Eli Lilly that in this clinical trial result, it was approved in 1998, then 12-year survival rate is 18%. If you look at 2% to 18%, right? 10% increase. But here's the number, okay? Look at this curve. 1 year, that's 1 year. So 5-FU is 2%, gemcitabine is 18%. If you look at curve, they will die. But this is a big news at that time. If you look at this data, but you know, data depends on how you show the data, okay? This data looks very nice, but when you look at this one, if I look at this, what's the difference? 2 months. What's the big deal? Hey, I'm my friend. Cancer patient, 2 months is a big deal. Right? So anyway, and pancreatic cancer 1998 like that. Up to now, it's similar. For how many years now? Almost 20 years. That whatever combination, the best is still 23% by combination for 12 months. Not even 5-year survival rate. We don't even talk about 5-year survival rate. Because you don't want to talk about 5-year survival rate for pancreatic cancer because you're frustrated. You're mentally sick. A couple percent. What are you talking about? Therefore, they use 12-month survival rate. Usually cancer, people talk about 5-year survival rate. Why you talk about 12-month survival rate? Because it's too low. Right? Now, 23%, 80%, what's different? There's no different. Well, there's some different, 5% different. Somebody interested? Go for it. There are a lot of method. There are a lot of new therapy, including that immunocheckpoint therapy, this clinical trial is ongoing. Pancreatic cancer? MD Anderson has a very aggressive program. And I'm part of that program. The person who heading for that program told me, Ming-Chi, our goal is add one more zero there. From at that time we talked about it 4%. He said, let's aim it 40%. I asked him, how long you think it will take? Then he told me, it depends on you and me. I feel so proud. We are in the stage that, I'm not saying we're going to reach that point, but based on the experience we have, we feel if everything is appropriate, it is not impossible. And just show you the picture. Everybody knows this guy, right? Very few people know this guy. He's a Nobel laureate in the same year. They all died in the same year, 2011. And he, I believe, is the first Nobel laureate receive a Nobel laureate when he already died. Because he was pancreatic cancer, and when the Nobel Committee announced that he was dying. So there was a debate because the Nobel Prize is supposed to give the people who are still alive. So there's a debate, should they give them? But he did receive a Nobel Prize. And then this one I don't have to talk about, everybody know him. You don't know him, you go to airport, all his picture is there. Or the book, Steve Jobs, right? They all die with pancreatic cancer, okay? Pancreatic cancer indeed is a difficult disease. And it doesn't say it's impossible, we just need something. And I will tell you what kind of stuff we need.